Here we will discuss special cases of the RH criterion. Okay, so when will a special case arise? When the element in the first column is zero. So here you have two cases. Okay, in case one, only the first element of a zero, first element of a row is zero. Okay, and the second case is when all the elements of a row is becoming zero. Okay, so we will first discuss case one by means of an example. So the characteristic polynomial of a feedback control system is given like this. Okay, and for this you have to find out the number of roots that lie in the left half and the right half of the S plane. Okay, so for this characteristic equation we will construct the Routh array. Okay, so it will start from S power 5, S power 4, S cube, S square, S to the power 1 and S to the power 0. Okay, so the first two rows are straightforward. Okay, so the first row will start from 1, that is the coefficient of S power 5. Okay, and then from 1 you have 2, 11. Okay, so 1, 2 and 11. And the second row will start from the coefficient of S power 4, that is 2. Okay, so it will be 2, 4 and 10. Okay, so you have 2, 4 and 10. Okay, now here you can see that 2 into 2 minus 1 into 4 divided by 2 will become 0 here. Okay, so you have the first one element in the first column is 0, that is the first element in the third row is 0. Okay, and the other element 2 into 11 minus 1 into 10 divided by 2, you will get 6. Okay, and here again you will get 0. Okay, so 6 is non-zero, so not all the elements are 0, only the first element of the row is 0. Okay, so this is case 1. Okay, so in this case what we have to do is we have to replace this 0 by some epsilon, which is a very small positive value. Okay, so we will assume a value epsilon, okay, instead of 0 here. So this you will get epsilon. Okay, and next you will have 4 epsilon minus 12 divided by epsilon, and here you will get 10 epsilon by epsilon, which is 10. Next, in this row we again have to multiply these two values minus these two values divided by this value. Okay, so here you will get 24 epsilon minus 72 minus 10 epsilon square divided by 4 epsilon minus 12. Okay, and here you will get 0 and 0. Okay, this we will get 10. So once we assume all the values, all the elements using epsilon, now we have to find out what is the sign of these values. Okay, so epsilon we took it as a small positive value. Okay, so for the S cube row the element is positive. Okay, for the next element, that is 4 epsilon minus 12 by epsilon, okay, we have to take the limit of epsilon tends to 0 plus. Okay, it is nearly 0, but since it is a positive value, it is approaching 0 from the positive side. Okay, so this limit epsilon tends to 0 plus 4 epsilon minus 12 will give you limit epsilon tends to 0 plus 4 minus 12 by epsilon. Okay, now epsilon is almost 0, so 12 by epsilon will be a very high value. Okay, but since it is having a negative sign, this whole expression will be less than 0. So the first element of S square row is negative. Okay, so we have one sign change here. Epsilon is positive, and from epsilon to 4 epsilon minus 12 by epsilon, it is changing from positive to negative. Okay, and then we have to consider the next element, that is 24 epsilon minus 72 minus 10 epsilon square divided by 4 epsilon minus 12. Okay, this is limit epsilon tends to 0 plus. Okay, so this will be equal to minus 72 by minus 12, which is equal to 6, and this is greater than 0. So again, this is a positive value, so there is a sign change from negative to positive, from s square to s to the power 1 rho. Okay, and again 10 is positive value. So here you have two sign changes. Okay, so since there are two sign changes, the system is unstable. Okay, the system is unstable with two roots in the right half of the S plane. Okay, since this is an equation of order 5, there will be 5 roots, out of which 2 are lying in the RHP. So there should be 3 more roots in the left half of S plane. So the answer to this question is 3 roots on the LHP and 2 roots on the RHP. So it is option C. Okay, so what is the procedure that we did for this case 1? Whatever element that we got as 0, we took it, we assumed it to be an element epsilon. Okay, we replaced 0 with epsilon, and epsilon is a small positive value. Okay, and the Routh table is constructed just as it is with the epsilon. Okay, and once the Routh table is completed, okay, we take the each and every value which is containing epsilon, and we are verifying the sign of that element. Okay, and depending on these sign changes, you can find out the stability of the system. Okay, but one thing that you have to consider in this case is, it will not work well if the roots are lying on the j omega axis. Okay, in that case the result will not be correct. The next special case of the RH criteria is when all elements of a row are becoming zero. All elements of row are zero. Okay, so for this also we will consider an example. S power 4 plus 2s cube plus 11s square plus 18s plus 18 is equal to 0. Okay, so this is the characteristic equation that is given. So what is the first step here? The first step is always to construct the Routh array. Okay, so we will first construct the Routh array, s power 4, s cube, s square, s to the power 1 and s to the power 0. Okay, so what will be the first row? It will start from the coefficient of s to the power 4, which is 1 in this case. Okay, coefficient of s to the power 4, coefficient of s square and coefficient of s to the power 0. Okay, so you have 1, 11 and 18. And the second row, it will start from the coefficient of s cube, which is 2 in this case. Okay, so coefficient of s cube and coefficient of s to the power 1, which is 18. Okay, here you can write 0. Okay, now 2 into 11 is 22 minus 1 into 18 divided by 2 will give you 2. It will give you 4 by 2, which is 2. Okay, and again 2 into 18 minus 1 into 0 divided by 2 will give you 18. Okay, so here you can see that s cube and s square rows are becoming equal. So if you find out 2 into 18 minus 2 into 18 divided by 2, you will simply get 0. And again 2 into 0 minus 2 into 0, you will get 0. Okay, so all the elements of s to the power 1 row are becoming 0. So we have our case 2 here, where all the elements of a row are becoming equal to 0. So what should we do in this case? Here we have to form the auxiliary equation. Okay, so what is meant by auxiliary equation and how to form it? Okay, so since s to the power 1 row is becoming 0, the auxiliary equation is formed from the coefficients of the previous row, which is s square row in this case. Okay, so what are the coefficients of, what are the elements of s square row? 2 and 18. Okay, so here we will take 2s square because it is the s square row plus 18 into s to the power 0. Okay, alternate powers we will be taking. So this is equal to 0 and this will form the auxiliary equation. Okay, so 2s square plus 18 is equal to 0. Okay, and the next step is to differentiate the auxiliary equation with respect to s. So if you differentiate this equation, you will get 4s is equal to 0. Okay, 4 into s to the power 1. Now from this equation, you will fill the elements of the s to the power 1 row. Okay, so what is the coefficient of s to the power 1 here? It is 4. Okay, so you will, instead of writing 0 and 0, you will replace it by 4. And here it will be 0. Okay, because there is no other coefficient. Okay, so here you have 4 and 0. Okay, and again we will proceed normally only. Okay, 4 into 18 minus 2 into 0 divided by 4, you will get 18. Okay, so once you complete the route array, you have to remember one thing here. When all the elements of the row are becoming 0, okay, then it means that there are roots which are symmetric about the origin. Okay, for example, let us say you have roots like this. Okay, in such a case, you will have all the elements of the row becoming 0 because these roots are symmetric about the origin. Okay, and similarly, let us say you have roots like this, or you have roots like this. Okay, so all these cases, you have the elements becoming 0. Okay, but here you have to understand that in some cases the system is unstable. Like in this case, you have one root in the RHP, here you have two roots in the RHP, but here you have roots on the j omega axis. Okay, so in this case the system can be unstable, the system can be marginally stable, but the point is the roots will be symmetric about the origin. Okay, so that is when the elements of a particular row will become equal to 0. So what you have to do is, after you construct the route array, you will have to check for sign changes. Okay, and once you check for sign changes, you can see that there is no sign change here. Okay, but you cannot say that the system is stable yet. Okay, we have to check further for the roots of auxiliary equation. Okay, the roots of the auxiliary equation will also be the roots of the characteristic equation. Okay, so roots, the auxiliary equation is 2 square plus 18 is equal to 0. So you have s square plus 9 is equal to 0. So you have s is equal to plus or minus j3. So here you can see that there are roots which are lying on the imaginary axis or the j omega axis. Okay, so you have roots like this. Okay, you can see that the roots are symmetric about the origin. Okay, so here you can see that the system is marginally stable. So do not assume that since there is no change, the system is automatically stable. No, for this special case, since it is a special case, okay, if it is a normal case, it will depend only on the sign change. But for this special case, when there is no sign change, then you have to further check the roots of the auxiliary equation where they are lying. Okay, and depending on that, we can verify whether the system is marginally stable, and in some cases it can be unstable also. Okay, so what did we do in this case? We first constructed the route array. Okay, and whichever row is becoming 0 from the previous row, we are forming the auxiliary equation. We are differentiating the auxiliary equation. Okay, and from this differentiated auxiliary equation, we are forming the row which is becoming 0, we are replacing with the coefficients of this equation. Okay, and so we are completing the route array and we are checking for any sign changes. Okay, so if there are no sign changes, if there are sign changes, the system is unstable. If there are no sign changes, then you have to further check the roots of the auxiliary equation. Okay, So from here you will get whether the system is marginally stable or it is unstable.